Today, watching PTS English News, I'm Ethan Liu. In response to the epidemic, President Tsai Ing-wen posted on Facebook saying Taiwan will now follow a new disease control model of zero serious cases and effective control of mild cases.
The epidemic is spreading domestically as Taiwan's daily numbers of newly confirmed cases have reached triple digits for several consecutive days. President Tsai Ing-wen stated through Facebook on the 6th that Taiwan's epidemic prevention strategy should aim for disaster reduction and pursue zero severe cases and effective control of mild cases. This will point towards a new Taiwan model of moving forward and opening up. However, some legislators question whether the government is ready. In the face of the escalating epidemic, the public is still full of anxiety.
政府准备好了没有？相关的配套，那民众才能有所依循，才知道可能发生什么状况，才能做好准备。现在我们不在做所谓的精准疫调，我们要简化疫调，辅以科技防疫，然后不再扩大框列，要在居家隔离。
Chen Shizhong emphasized that in the future, epidemic prevention should gradually bring back life to normal, but the epidemic has recently spread to school campuses. According to the Ministry of Education statistics, as of the 6th, a total of 128 schools across 14 Taiwanese counties or cities have suspended all or some classes. Chen frankly said mass school closures are too strict and discussions will be held with the Ministry of Education next week.
停课的规定是不是有太严格了？就等于太严格了，就是说有两个以上就全校要来停课等等这些相关的规定，可以来做讨论。
Chen emphasized Taiwan's plan is to reduce the disaster. The country will provide good critical care and gradually relax its measures. In the future, quarantine and isolation will mainly be at home. He stressed that the relaxation of quarantine has nothing to do with upcoming elections. The Central Epidemic Command Center is expected to finalize guidelines for at-home care of mild illnesses next week. The CECC is expected to seek local government support to conduct a trial first, and at the same time, the center will prepare to purchase related drugs on a large scale.
大甲 Zhenlan Temple's Mazu pilgrimage will kick off as scheduled on the evening of April 8th despite the epidemic. The temple urged the worshippers, however, to get three doses while sharing food and scrambling under the palanquin will be prohibited.
People line up outside the temple with their vaccination cards to obtain the 3-OK card. Dajia Zhenlan Temple's Mazu pilgrimage is scheduled to kick off at 11 p.m. on April 8th. Its Mazu statue will then spend the next 9 days and 8 nights on a trip that will take it to 4 cities and counties. In light of the escalating epidemic situation, some believers have put their fate in the hands of the goddess, while others are taking more practical precautions. There were 382 local cases on April 7th, the highest daily total so far this year. The temple convened a press conference on April 7th. It said that temple officials are complying with Central Epidemic Command Center directives and are requiring all board members, staff, and accompanying media to have received three vaccine doses. However, it can only advise and not compel worshippers to get three doses. It said the central government should provide further guidelines.
防疫指挥中心这是内行的，到目前为止，庙方虽然以最严密的标准自我要求，但希望讲疫情指挥中心啊，能在办理这个绕境上做出明确的这个指导与协助。
The temple said worshippers are required to wear masks at all times. The palanquin won't be passed over the bodies of kneeling worshippers, and there won't be shared meals. The temple had prepared 20,000 of the 3-OK cards and all have been handed out. It is printing 20,000 more, and the service hours of the service desk were extended until 8 p.m. on April 7th. The cards will also be available from 9 a.m. on April 8th to 1 a.m. on April 9th.
Now, bring more stories from around Taiwan. Southeast Cement will face a compensation bill of $78.63 million after the company's demolition project went wrong and caused a power outage and rail delays that affected over 126,000 passengers. The Yunlin Second Prison has dispatched 11 inmates to help harvest garlic due to a lack of manpower. The county government said farmers can ask for help by a local farmers association if there's a need. A side entrance leading to an experimental forest in Yilan has been closed for over a year due to the epidemic, leading to complaints from hikers and residents. Yilan University say it will consider allowing entry once running registrations are implemented. The result of the primary to select the Democratic Progressive Party's candidate for Pingdong County Magistrate has been announced. The winner is legislator Zhou Chunmi, who has the backing of incumbent magistrate Pan Mengan. Zhou says she will speak with the two candidates she defeated, Zhong Jiabing and Zhang Ruixiong, to incorporate their views into her platform. The party won't formally nominate its candidate until its central committee approves the nomination. Former President Chen Shui-bian is currently on medical parole and convened an international press conference on April 7th, hoping to claim his innocence in the misuse of state affairs fund case.
民意是人的第二生命.
Former President Chen Shui-bian convened an international press conference on April 7th to claim his innocence. He said he is not guilty of corruption and brandished evidence showing that there were 21 payments from the State Affairs Fund that totaled 133 million NT dollars, which far exceeded the public intake of 104 million NT dollars. Chen was indicted in 2008 for misusing the State Affairs Fund. He also cited the acquittal of former President Ma Ying-jeou in a case involving the use of special funds during his time as Taipei mayor and accused the judicial system of double standards. Chen was sentenced to life in 2008 for his misuse of the State Affairs Fund. He appealed, and in the end, the Taiwan High Court ruled he was innocent in a first ruling. The Supreme Court rejected the sentence, and the second hearing is ongoing. Chen was released from prison on medical parole, and his case has been suspended. The Chen family lawyer says his wife, who is also a defendant, should get the same treatment. Chen held the press conference one day before the next court session on April 8th. There are also questions about whether holding this press conference violated the terms of his medical parole. He said this is a technicality, and the most important thing is to explain to the public the facts disclosed during past closed trials.
我有不法所得不，那是重点嘛。所以您讲到尾啊，讲到这些技术性的问题，非常小儿科技啊。对我来讲，既然我敢开这个记者会，哦，为了我的清白，我要做有力的辩护。
Deputy Justice Minister Tsai Bi-chung attended a legislative interpellation on April 7th and refused to answer any questions about whether Chen violated his medical parole terms by holding the press conference.
抱歉，抱歉，没有。抱歉，抱歉。这个事先了解过了吗？好，不请假吗？
Taichung Prison said it will collect related evidence to conduct an assessment. Chen was asked if he expects President Tsai Ing-wen to pardon him. He said he doesn't have any expectations because it's impossible.
Now, let's take a look at some international news today. NATO foreign ministers are expected to announce their commitment to step up military support for Ukraine after a two-day meeting. Some worry the move might just fuel more confrontations. Thailand has seen over 10,000 international visitors arrive a day as the country scrapped pre-flight COVID tests in April. The upcoming Songkran New Year holiday, however, will remain dry as water splashing won't be allowed. Hundreds of indigenous people in Brazil called their president devil and murderer during a 10-day protest as an effort to oppose his proposal that will allow mining and oil exploration on indigenous reservations. A research team from Chang'an University recently found that Chinese medicine ingredient Korlym is capable of extending lives.
This is P. Korylifolia, a Chinese traditional medicine ingredient. It contains Korlym, which a research team from Chang'an University has confirmed has life-prolonging properties. An international periodical has affirmed the results, raising the profile of Chinese medicine. The team has also filed for patents.
因为补骨脂里面的成分非常的多，我们也去鉴定了22种的那个纯化物的成分，最终发现里面有一个成分叫做补骨脂宁，可以有效的延长寿命。
The team found that Korlym extended the life expectancy of mice on high-fat diets by 20 to 30%. Humans have an average life expectancy of 75, so it's equivalent to extending it to 90 to 97.5. The team said that mice that consumed Korlym lived longer lives and had lower levels of cholesterol, triglycerides, and blood sugar. They also displayed improved exercise capacity and muscle strength, allowing for healthy aging. The team's long-term goal is to develop medications to treat aging-associated diseases. No clinical trials have been performed, so the public is discouraged from purchasing and using Korlym on their own.
Thank you for watching today's PTS English News. I'm Ethan Liu, and I will see you next time.